first is to say we are Full Gospel Churches of Kenya, Community Health Evangelism, in short we call it CHE, program of the church, Full Gospel, and we basically are focused on holistic transformation and targeting needy communities, mostly in the slum areas and also in some of the far-reached, far areas, parts of this country, like northeastern, northern Kenya, and other parts of the country. What is community health evangelism? I think it is good also to clarify. Community health evangelism is a Christ-centered tool that is used to address issues of poverty alleviation, and it combines the whole interpretation of the scripture that we need to the great commandment on one hand, love God, love your neighbor as yourself, and the great commandment, the great commission. So the great commandment about loving God and your neighbor, and the great commission of going to make disciples. So that in a nutshell is who we are. We've been in operation since 2016. And so this is coming up to our fourth year in operation, and we are grateful to God. 13th of March 2020, this year, when the first case of COVID was announced in Kenya, it seems a long time ago, that is just about 3 months ago. A lot has happened since then, and as a community transformation or a community development ministry or project, we sat down and asked ourselves, what can we do to be part of addressing issues of COVID and helping our people on the ground? Because as at then, it became very apparent, immediately shortly after that, meetings were banned, and the churches were closed, schools were closed, and for a while, I think, as a country, we seem to have gone through a shock in terms of trying to adjust to their new realities. And as a program of Full Gospel CHE, we basically sat down and spent time praying and asking ourselves, what would Jesus do in a situation like this? And that led us to realize that we cannot afford just to sit down and wait for COVID to end or for life to go back to normal. We thought of a number of projects and a number of activities we've been doing. The first one of the project was basically doing community awareness, COVID awareness in five communities that we are actively involved. And so that was mostly from April, most of April and a bit of early May. We went to the communities, that is in Nairobi, we are working two communities in Waidaka, that is in Dagoretti sub-county. We work in Shiranga, which is in Kasarani sub-county. We work also out of Nairobi in northern Kenya, in a place called Oldonyiro. Maybe some people may not know where that is, but it's somewhere between Nanyuki and Maralal. We also work in Isiolo, on the outskirts of Isiolo town, a place called Mwangaza. It's a peri-urban setting. And then we also work in the Rift Valley, in Kericho. Throughout the county of Kericho, we serve those communities. So the first phase one of intervention was community awareness, through what we call the CHE champions. CHE champions are people who we have trained, mostly they are pastors or key leaders in the communities where we work, in those five communities. They have gone through the CHE training, and they are able to spearhead our work. So through these CHE champions, we at phase one, we basically, as an office, we provided washing hand soap. We provided, in some cases, masks. We provided gloves. We provided disinfectants, chlorine, and also provided the spraying pump. And through that, then in all those five communities, we are able to engage, go door to door where possible, or disinfect the public areas, do public awareness in some places. It was possible to use public address systems to do mass awareness. In other places, that wasn't possible. But overall, that was very, very successful. And it was basically to encourage people on the interventions of COVID to wash your hands thoroughly and frequently, social distancing, no greeting, and issues like that. When you're sneezing or coughing, you cough into an elbow or into a mask or something of that nature. I think it would be good to just explain a little bit further that when we went to the communities and did the public awareness, the teams on the ground are also trying to find out what are some of the needs, what are some of the challenges, and getting feedback. I forgot to mention that we worked very closely with the public health officers on the ground, with the area, the government officers, the area chiefs and the sub chiefs, and the assistant county commissioners and the county commissioners who are necessary. So from all that, I forgot also that during that time we were also able to engage in terms of, we thought that whereas face-to-face engagement and public awareness is good, but we slowly realized that it was actually important to perhaps reach a much more wider community. So that's when we engaged a couple of radio and TV, local radio and TV stations. In Nairobi, we engaged Mtani Radio, based in reaching Kawangware and that whole area, for which we are very grateful for that partnership. We in Kericho, we engaged Radio Injili, which is reaching most of the Rift Valley and Western Kenya and the South Rift, very, very effective. And in Kisumu, we also engaged Lolwe TV, and again, reaching most of Nyanza and the environment. So out of all those, we realized a couple of things out of the feedback from phase one. One, people are very happy and very encouraged that we did not forget about them. Two, we are very impressed by the level of creativity. As the teams went out, a number of teams engaged in making tippy taps or innovative ways of washing hands, equipment, and some used tippy taps and all that. That was really encouraging. Others were able to think through how to make masks using locally available materials and stuff. But one thing which, as that was going on, and we decided to roll that into phase two, but one thing we noticed in all the five locations is that because of COVID restrictions, there were a number of people who are really suffering. They had lost their jobs, either they had lost their jobs or they were no longer able to, their businesses had collapsed. And basically, especially among the old, the elderly and the vulnerable population. And so the resounding question from all these five locations was there any way of helping these people materially?